Hello everyone. My name is Franklin Abung'ana. Welcome to my online tutorials, where I give you the insight on emerging technological issues affecting matters in education. Subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on my upcoming tutorials. Subscription is free. You won't be charged anything instead. You will be notified whenever I upload a new video. Welcome and keep on learning.
Hi, welcome to part 3 of my tutorial on timetabling using aSc software. Now, I'm breaking this into units so that you can get the whole picture of the parts and processes involved in timetabling using aSc. Someone asked, why can't I come up with a video explaining the whole process? Now, teaching being my profession, we don't teach units, neither do we teach topics. Instead, we break them into subtopics, which I believe they'll be even more helpful and easier to understand than going through the whole process at a go. Now, this is our demo timetable. I will open it, and the last time we were on adding subjects. Now you can access our previous section on subjects using this button, or you can come down here. You can also access it from that point, but I want to take you through the wizard, which has 7 steps that will take you through a complete process of creating a timetable. So I'll go to specification, then wizard. I'll click on next until I get where we were last week. So this is where we were. These are the subjects we had added. And remember, you can manage your subjects from this section. You can select a given subject, you can edit, you can remove, and for the issue of lessons, time off and constraints, we shall look at them later. You can as well move a given subject up using this arrow, or you can move down a given subject. You can see I've moved English just below mathematics. I can take it back where it was, use the first on the row. So we shall see how these buttons work as we proceed. Now I'll click on next. For today, we are going to discuss on how to add classes and classrooms. Now, to add a classroom, you can see at the top here, we are supposed to enter classes. So to enter classes, you can see the green arrow where it is. So I'll click on new, and then I'll add our first class. That should be grade one. I'll leave it that way even for the short form, and I'll come down here and select grade 1. Though it is not necessary for you to select, you can leave it the way it is and then click on OK. I'll also click on new and then add grade 2. I'll also leave it the way it is for the short form, then come down here and select grade 2. Click on OK. I'll also go back and add our third class, which is grade 3. I'll come down here and select grade 3. I'll click on OK. So we have added our 3 classes. Remember, for the CBC curriculum lower, we have those 3 classes, and we are making a timetable for those 3 classes. I said we shall advance as we move forward on how we can even make a timetable for the whole school. Now, the next step, I'll click on next. Now that we have classes, and remember, you can still manage classes from this point. You can select for you to edit or remove a given class. with the lessons time off and constraint are still there, we shall look at them later. You can as well reorganize your classes. You can move it down or you can move it up. And then I'll click on next, where we shall add or enter classrooms. Classrooms are very important, especially where we have limited number of classes, that is at the buildings where learners are supposed to attend the classes. But for an ideal institution where we have maybe sufficient classes, this section is not actually mandatory. You can create a timetable with this section, but for the sake of having a variety of timetables, I normally generate my classes from here. So I'll come to generate and then click OK. Now what I normally do, I simply select given class and then click on edit. I'll delete the home classroom. I'll delete that part and click on OK. And also that we have grade 1, I'll click on the second, click on edit, and then remove that issue of a classroom, and then I'll click on OK. I'll move to grade 3, click on edit, then remove the issue of classrooms, and then I'll click on OK. So generally that is what I normally do as far as classrooms are concerned. But you can make use of this section, especially on the PE lessons, whereby classes are supposed to attend the PE lessons in the playground. You can have a scenario whereby all the classes are in the field, so you can actually moderate that using this section, but we shall come to that as we move forward. So thank you for watching part 3 of my tutorial. Bye.
I hope you have learned something from this tutorial. If so, give this video a big thumbs up, comment, and share. Above all, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell on so that you don't miss out on my upcoming uploads. Thank you for watching. See you then.